In this lecture, we are going to learn how we can use this laser transmitter that transmits laser beam. And this is the laser receiver that receives and detects the laser beam and will send a signal which we will detect using Arduino. One way that this can be used, as you have seen it in some movies, is that this sends continuous signal. The laser is hitting this and we are detecting that the signal has been reached here. And the establishment of the signal means no obstacle. And when an obstacle or something comes and cuts the laser beam, it will be detected with Arduino and we take action. For example, we turn on an alarm or maybe turn on lights or send a picture or SMS, whatever action you want to take based on the obstacle existence between the two transmitter and receiver. And the laser beam can be viewed when an object or something comes in front of it. You will be able to see the laser beam. This can be used as a counter. Every time the signal is blocked, you can count and increment the number. The transmitter, this is the laser beam transmitter, and they made it as a module, and they have provided three pins here. This is the negative or ground. This is the signal. We are not going to send some specific signal. We just turn it on continuously. So this can be used as a counter or as an obstacle avoidance. So we will be using only this left and right pin, and the middle pin will not be used. And this is the receiver. The receiver, however, has ground pin and VCC, so ground is on that side, VCC is on this side, and the middle pin is an output, and it continuously needs 5 volts to operate. And when the laser beam hits this lens here, this is the receiver, this output pin will go high, and we can detect it using Arduino to take action. When you purchase this module, you will receive it something like this, and when you are inserting it, pay attention to this, and on this side is flat, and we have a lens on this side. The lens side must be inserted. Make sure that this is the flat side, and the lens must be facing the pins or inside the module. Here is the wiring diagram that I have drawn using first thing. The transmitter have been connected from this side, which has negative. This has been connected to the ground using green wire. And the S or the signal pin, which is on the left, have been connected using a blue wire to pin 13. The receiver on the right side, this is VCC. This has been connected to 5 volts. On the left side, this has been connected to the ground. The middle pin, which is the output from this transmitter, have been connected to pin 2, where we will read it at this pin. And here is the wiring on the Arduino. The green wire from the right, from the negative, have been connected to the ground of Arduino, this ground that we have in here. And the blue pin, the signal, have been connected to pin 13. And here for the receiver, VCC from this using white wire have been connected to 5 volts. On the left, the ground have been connected via this pink pin to this ground. And the middle wire, which is the output, have been connected using the gray wire to pin 2. Let me explain now the code. We define a pin 2 as detect pin, and we define pin 13 for transmitter. This is the pin that transmitter will receive the power. And also we are defining action pin, pin 8. This pin 8 can be connected to a relay, which we have explained so many times in other videos, or it can be connected to a light or buzzer, whatever you want. In this case, I'm going to connect it to a buzzer. Inside the setup, we initialize a serial monitor with 9600 baud. This is the rate that when you open the serial monitor, it must match. This is just printing the text on the screen. And then we define detect pin, detect, transmit, action, three of those here using the pen mode as input. Detect is an input, action is an output, and transmit is also as an output. After this line, we use digital write, and for the transmit, we set it high, so this continuously gives power to the transmitter. Inside the loop, using digital read, we read the detect pin, and the result of that detection value will be stored in the detected variable of type integer. And here we use a if statement and check that detected if it is equal low. We've used two equal sign to compare these two, and low means when an obstacle blocks it and there is no laser, we will detect it, and then we send the action pin high. This can be connected to a buzzer. Also, we print this on the screen, obstacle detected. If this is not low, which means the laser beam is continuously shining and the pin is high, then we use else, because if it's not low, it will be high. Else, then we send the buzzer to low, so the buzzer is off, and also we print this clear on the screen, and we wait 200 milliseconds and continuously read this using this loop. I pointed the transmitter towards this receiver at this point, but still it's off, so I have to make sure that it is shining to this, and as you can see, it shows obstacle detected. It's detected mean that the signal is not reaching, so I have to make sure that we read here clear. Now it says clear, and I have to put something underneath of this to lift this up. You can see at the moment it shows clear. The reason for that is the laser beam is hitting here and the reflection is being detected, and this is problematic, and make sure that you point it directly to the device, not from the reflection. After working and trying to adjust it, now it's perfectly hitting this receiver. Now if any objects or anything comes in between, as soon as you block it, you will see that it says obstacle detected. I put this breadboard, it says detected and clear and detected, and that's the laser beam that is hitting here. This can work for very long distance, maybe hundreds of meters, but the problem is that the further you put these transmitter and receiver apart, the harder will be pointing the beam to the receiver. Now I'm connecting this 5 volts buzzer. On this side, this will be connected to pin 8, and this negative side will be connected to the ground. Now, because the beam is not aligned, the buzzer is on, so I have to align it and make sure that it is not on. I was able to align it. Now, as you can see, the beam is shining here. And if I block the beam using a simple paper, the alarm will turn on. If you want to delay the alarm, detect it, and this should stay on for longer period, just add 5000 milliseconds, for example, to keep this running when obstacle is detected. Now if I create an obstacle, this will be on for 5 seconds before it goes off.